Guys, welcome to day number 7. We are finally here. I'm so excited that you're made it this far, guys. Let's just go ahead and start with some deep breaths in through the nose. Feel the belly expand. Exhale, press the breath out. Good. Just breathe in that fresh air. Wherever you are practicing today, exhale, press it out. One more time. Breathe deep in through the nose and out through the nose. Good. Now take your hands together this time and inhale as you raise up and press the hands to the sky. Push the chin to the chest. Reach to the right as you keep your left hip on the ground. Extend through the side of your body. Good. And inhale, bring it up and over to the left. Exhale and hold. Keep your left hip on the floor. Big side stretch. Good. Back to the top and round forward. Release the fingers. Take a nice deep breath in and reach over to the right. So a little different today. We're just adding a couple different moves. Inhale to your left. Good. This should feel nice and really relaxing now. Starting to move, to make the movements a little bigger today. Really get the most out of today's practice. This is the final day of the 7-day challenge. Good. Take one more breath in and exhale down. Let's move into downward dog. So take those hands under the shoulders. Take those toes, tuck them under and raise it up. So pressing the hips to the sky. Just go ahead and walk the dog again. Sending your chest and rotating and breathing. Good. Just get a big stretch here. Enjoy the movements today. Good. Nice and big reach. And I'll drive both heels to the floor. Rise the hips up and come forward. Bend those elbows. You can drop the knees to the floor or just lower down. Inhale, scoop up. Open it up. And then we go ahead and add that twist. Good. Looking over shoulder to shoulder. Good. And just rotating those feet. Nice. Let's do two more. Good. And last one, lift up. You can drop the knees if you'd like. Open up through the chest. Tuck your toes. Push back. Down dog. Good. Let's take a step forward into our forward fold. Let your body hang. Good. Inhale. Come up halfway. Lengthen out through the torso. You know these moves. Exhale and fold. Well, inhale. Come all the way up to the top. Open up the chest. Exhale. Pull those elbows back into cactus. Inhale. Come back up. Exhale. Roll down. Release down. Good. Shake the head. Inhale. Come up halfway again. And exhale. Come down. We're going to lower back down into plank. Good. Now I want you to just go ahead and push the hips up into down dog. We're going to raise the right leg. This is a little different. And as you come in, we're going to bring that knee to the chest. A little core move here. I did think we did this on poor day, right? Lift that knee. Lift that leg. Pull the knee in. Hold. Two more times. Lift it up. And bring it in. One more time, lift it up, and bring it in. Good, push it back to down dog. Nice. We're gonna take that left leg now and pull it up and draw it in. So try to really bring it to the chest and then lift the toes up to the sky. Draw it in, pull the belly in tight two more times. Good, exhale, pull it in. Inhale up one more time. Exhale, drag it in and push it up. Take it down. Let's walk the dog. All right, we're going to do a little hip opener next. So I just want you to come forward first. Let's float down through our vinyasa. Lower down. Inhale. Scoop up. Shoulders back and down. Good. Tuck your toes. Push back. Nice. So we're going to take that leg, right leg up again. I want you to flex your foot and bend that knee open. You're going to look underneath your right arm and just open up that hip. Now lift your knee a little more. Push that foot back. Feel a nice deep release in that hip. Breathe in. Breathe out. Can you push that leg further back? Just feel that hip open. It should feel really good, really tight. Really good stretch for those hips. And then rotate back to the center. Come back in. Now take your elbow to the knee to the elbow and push back. Let's do it again to the elbow. Abs are working. Push back. Two more times. Exhale, elbow. Push back. And one more time, elbow, you got it, push back. Bring it down, down dog, walk the dog. Good, take the stickers out of your legs. Good, and push back. Really push the chest towards your feet. Now open up that chest, shoulders back and down. Let's come forward as we float down, knees or toes. Inhale and press up, open up through the chest. Nice, take that deep breath in. Come down, tuck your toes, push back. Down dog as the left leg raises, flex that foot,
Open up that hip, turn to look under the left. Good, now lift your knee a little, push your foot back, and really feel that open of the hip. Good, keep pushing a little bit further if you can. Keep those arms straight. Good, keep breathing, lifting, and then rotating back to center. Come forward to plank and take that knee to your elbow. Working the core, the side of the waist, lift. Do it again. Feel the cool weather coming in. Two more. It's a little later today. Press back one more time. Pull it in, work those abs. Push it back. Good, take it down. Push the hips back. Come forward, step your feet in. A lot of movement today. If you need a break, go ahead and take it. You can rest in down dog or child's pose. Inhale, scoop up. Open it up, give me that cactus. Open up those elbows, shoulders back. Inhale, come up. Exhale, swan dive over your legs. Bring it up to halfway raise. Look out, exhale, fall forward. Bend the knees and step back. Good, we're gonna lower to chaturanga. Inhale, scoop up, shoulders back and down. And then press back. All right, let's hold on to some poses. Now let's take the right leg up. And let's just step that foot just in between your hands. Again, knee over your ankle. Keep that back heel lifted. Take your hands on your thighs and lift up for crescent pose. So in crescent, we push that heel back. Feeling a nice stretch in this back hip. Take your arms over your head or keep them on your thigh. Sink down into the front foot and your back toes push back. Your heel reaches back. Chest is open. You can do a little bend here if you want back bend or just reach straight up. Good. Hold. Good, deep breath in and out. Now take your body halfway over, right over the leg. Take your arms overhead and then bring them out into airplane wings. Hold it, lengthen out the crown of your head and continue reaching your hands back until they clasp together and pull back, reaching them back, pulling your forehead towards either your knee or your ankle. Pull those arms up and hold here. How low did you go? If you need to, you could drop this back knee to modify, lift and reach. Good. And then pull yourself back up. Raise those arms back into crescent. That was tough. Bring it down, step back, lower down, chaturanga. We have the other side. Bring it up, inhale, scoop up. Shoulders back and down, really feel that breath move in. Exhale, tuck back, lower down. Down dog, you can use those little dog walking, twisting moves. Just keep that body moving and breathing. Hold here, down dog, and get ready for the left leg up. Good, let's pull that knee all the way forward. Foot comes in between, knee over ankle. Back heel's down, back heel is lifted. Fix the hair, keep your hand on your thighs or reach them up. Pushing the hips down, pressing that heel back. Open up the chest, you can lean back. Look up, shoulders away from your ears. Hold and breathe. Now try to get into the best crescent pose you can while you're breathing. One more breath here, reach further, and then dive over that leg. Reach those arms out, crown of the head forward, and extend your arms to airplane. Good, your rib shack should be resting on that thigh. Then take your hands behind you, clasp your fingers, little stretch forward down. You can hold here, or you can continue down as your arms reach up. Taking your forehead towards that ankle. All the way up with your arms, feel that big stretch, and release, breathing in. And out. These moves are challenging today, so do your best, modify as you need. Come back up, reach those arms above your head, continuing into crescent, and then fold forward, step back. Let's continue into our vinyasa. Lower, inhale, scoop up, shoulders down. How's your posture been now that you're doing yoga? You should be more focused on that posture. Let's bring the right leg up again. Bring it in front. Good, take the back foot. Pivot that heel flat, come up, reach up for warrior one, sink into that hip, reach the arms up over your chest, shoulders are down. Now I'm gonna turn away from you. Warrior two, arms are reaching, sink into this foot, back heel presses. Take this back arm, reach over your ear, looking up to the sky, big smile, big breath, come forward. Warrior two, bring that back arm down, lift up to warrior one. And as you exhale, just fold forward. Back foot flat, pivot, step this foot back. Coming back down, inhaling, moving to the left side. Good, tuck the toes, push back. Hopefully that heart rate's coming up today. Raise that left leg up as high as you can. pull that foot between the hands, pivot the back foot flat. Bring those arms up, warrior one, sink into that front knee, push the back heel, pull yourself towards that front thigh, raise those arms up, and open out to warrior two, eyes forward. Reach those elbows, shoulders down and back. Breathe in, breathe out, sink down into the stretch. Take your back hand on that leg, reach up and over. Eyes to the sky, look underneath that elbow, reach that arm as far back as it'll go. Hands soft on the leg, and back to warrior two. Extend those shoulders and arms. Slide this hand down, warrior one, raise it up, and exhale, dive forward. We're kind of sinking everything into this practice today. Kind of making it a flow of all the others, a culmination of all the other practices. Good, bring the knees down, send yourself into child's, and we rock side to side. Nice. And just as promised, we keep these workouts 20 minutes or less. We push the hips back. Take a deep breath in here, exhale, melt into the floor. Do this two more times, breathe in, exhale out. One more time, breathe in, exhale out, coming into hands and knees. Let's bring that right knee in between your hands. Let's go right into our pigeon pose again. Now if you want to, you can bend the back knee, or you can keep that back top of your thigh on the floor. This foot can be close to your hip, or to make it harder, you can move it up a little bit closer to your armpit as you come down. So arms are nice and wide, lift your chest. And you're gonna feel a nice big release in this hip. Raise the hip, chest up, open up the shoulders, or drop the shoulders, lift the chest. Breathe in. As you breathe out, walk your hands out one step at a time. You're gonna feel a deeper stretch release in that hip. Inhale, exhale, walk out. Now the idea is to lengthen out through the torso as you extend forward and feel that great hip release. Again, the more you sit all day, the more you're in your car, at your computer, your desk, the tighter your hips become. So we really need to use these stretches to release tension and stress. Good, and then just kind of collapse. We'll hold here for three breaths. Exhale, try to come a little bit longer in that spine, that torso. Inhale and exhale down. One more time. Exhale, slide down into that hip as much as you can. Now walk your hands in. We're gonna stay here. Watch this next move. We're gonna raise the back foot. Take this right hand and reach behind you. Can you grab the foot? If not, just lift it and hold it there. If you can wrap your hand around the leg, pull that foot as close to you can. Even take the hand on the outside of the foot and just pull it as close to you as you can. Open up the chest. Find what works. If this is crazy to you, just take your hand to the floor. Lift your chest. Keep that breath flowing. Now we're first gonna release it if you're holding on. Take the hand down, walk your hands in, tuck the back toes, slide that knee in. Uncross this knee, push back, child's. All right, rock side to side before we do the other leg. One side of the body's nice and relaxed. Let's release that other hip. Let's come forward and let's slide that left knee in. Now again, back thigh, your right thigh stays on the floor. This left foot can be low, or you can walk it up a little bit more, but your hands are wide. Open up through the chest, lift up, inhale. As you exhale, walk out. Good, just try to wiggle into that pose. Breathe in and exhale. Feel that release in that hip. Relax your shoulders too, your face, everything releases. And exhale. These ants here love to bite me. I had a bite on my back and just itched for days. So I'm gonna try to use my mat, but just release into the floor. Inhale, you want to exhale, just kind of want to fall over that leg. Feel that hip stretch and release. Two more breaths, guys. Let it go. All of that stress is pouring into the floor. Again, that hip is just releasing. After that final breath, you're going to slowly rise up. Keep your legs where they are. We're going to raise that other foot. Take this left hand, wrap it around. If you can, grab your foot, inside or outside. Pull it in. This side's a little tighter, so I'm gonna hold it here. Lift your chest. You notice one side of your body might be different. You just take that, you know, as caution. Listen to your body's limitations. Respect them. And just fall into it as you can breathe and release a little deeper every time. Good, let's release that foot. Take your hands in, tuck your back toe, slide it back into down dog. Nice. Now we have that little cross. I'm gonna do another little challenge with you. Come forward. Take your right knee towards your left elbow, right? Take it back again, down dog. Take your left knee towards your left elbow and then down dog. Now let's raise that right leg up and do the same thing. Take it to the elbow, bring it right back up. Let's do that four more times. Bring it to the outside elbow, pull it back up. Good, bring it to the elbow. You can make these moves smaller if you want to. I'm just showing you how to challenge yourself. If you're up for it today, one more time. Bring it in and back up. Nice, take it down, press into down dog. Nice, and let's add that left leg. Bring it up. Now let's come into plank and bring that knee across towards your opposite elbow. Pull it back up four more times. Exhale, really twist and move. Bring it back up. Inhale. Exhale, cross it under. You got two more. Inhale, lift. Exhale, cross it under. One more time. And exhale, cross it under. Pull it all the way up. Send it down. And we're going to come forward to plank. Walk it up. We're going to stand up. Let yourself fall forward. Halfway raise, lengthen, exhale, fall forward, inhale, roll up. We have people yelling in the background today. Let's try a new pose we've not done called Eagle. So I want you to take your feet together. Take your arms over your head. Take your right arm. As you move your arms out to the side, your right arm's gonna wrap under your left, okay? Try that again. Right arm goes under your left. Hook that elbow in the wrist. Now take your hands and try to wrap them around so that palms are facing each other. They don't have to touch. Bring the elbows down into the chest. Now sit into your chair. You can simply hold here, lifting your chest, raising those hands up, pulling your elbows down, feeling a great stretch across your shoulder. If you want to add more, tap your right toes, lift your foot and wrap it around your left, and you can wrap your toes around your ankle. A lot to do, I know. But I want you to pull your knees and your elbows in a straight line. So your elbows are gonna try to align over the knees. Might not be there today, but you will get there. Sit back into your chair, lift your chest. You're squeezing your inner thighs and your chest and your shoulders together. Breathing in, breathing out. Again, pushing everything to the center. Breathing in, breathing out. One more time before we unwrap. Breathe in. Breathe out, sink a little deeper, and unwrap and release. Take a nice deep breath in. Open out to cactus. Inhale, bring it up. Exhale, fall forward. And inhale, halfway raise. We're gonna do the other side, all the way back up to the top. And let's wrap the left elbow now underneath. So try it again. Left elbow wraps underneath that right. Wrap the forearms, palms slightly touching or facing each other, elbows down. Sit in your chair, hold here if this is enough. This is hard. If you want to add that left foot, it's always my tighter side. Lift it up, you can do it a couple times. Wrap it around. I have limited availability to wrap that ankle, the toes around, but I'm gonna stay here. So you can always touch the toes to the ankle. Lift your chest, sit down in that chair. Elbows aligned slightly over your knees. You're twisting your knees to the center, elbows towards the center, lifting your chest, breathing in. Breathing out, trying to wrap those toes. Don't think I'm gonna make it today. Breathing in, breathing out. One more time. Breathe a deep breath. Exhale, release the breath. Now inhale, we're gonna unwrap. And exhale, release. Breathe in, exhale, swan dive. All the way out, walk your feet out. All right, just hang forward, guys. Swing side to side. Like a pendulum, swing. Good, we're gonna take the hands, walk them forward, lengthen out through the torso. Now we're gonna walk the hands, turn the fingers back and walk them through your legs. Try to get the crown of the head to face the floor. Good, now walk them out again. Lengthen out, we'll do it one more time. Try to get a little bit length, more length here. Turn your fingers back and walk them back. You're pulling the crown of your head towards the ground. Good, and come back to the center. Good, bending into the right thigh, pushing your hip away, keeping this foot down. Nice, keeping this hand down if you need. Nice, just feeling a nice deep stretch in this inner thigh. This is more of a stretch than a yoga pose, but it really feels good.
And we really need to stretch out those inner thighs more often than we do. All right, guys, we're wrapping it up, getting to the end of today's practice. Release down, taking your hands on your thighs all the way out. Good. And then we're going to bend the knees and roll up, taking your feet all the way in. Let's have a seat. We have our four-part hip opener, and we're going to close. So let's take those legs out. Inhale, raise your arms up. Exhale, fall forward, reaching as far as you can and pulling your chest towards your toes. Feel the length and extension of your spine. Your chest is extending out, and you relax forward. If you can wrap your hands around your ankles, fine. If you're at your toes, if you're at your feet, doesn't matter how far you're holding. It matters that you're lengthening and you're breathing and you're feeling that stretch. If you can't breathe, you went too far, so back off. Good. Come up, let's take the right knee, bend it. Take that foot across. Left arm's going to hug that knee, right hand behind your hip. Lift your chest, turn and look back. So your spine is lifted, you're turning and you're twisting and looking over your shoulder. We're going to come back to center, cross this ankle over the thigh, bring the arms back into your L position, exhale, dive forward for a deeper stretch in the hamstrings. Inhale, exhale, and hold. Good. These stretches are brief, but I want you to make the most out of them with your breath. Oh, we're excited today. Someone is yelling. Bring that foot as close to you as you can. Push this knee away, hands on the floor by your hips, and open up through the chest. You want to feel a great hip open again. Exhale, we're gonna drop the knees over, foot all over to the side, turn and wrap that knee into the chest one more time. Look over your shoulder, twisting and lifting, lifting and twisting. And let's repeat that on the left side. So take those legs out again, one more side, guys. Exhale, reach out, pull your chest forward, release into that stretch. Maybe you can go deeper this time. Good, and bring it up. Take that left knee, bend it. Take that foot across. Now your right arm hugs the knee. Keep your spine long. Push that hand in the floor. Turn and look over your shoulder. Raise the body up nice and tall. Exhale and twist. So good for your spine to do these twists every single day. Taking care of your spine. Bring you back to the center. Take that ankle across. Fix the hair. Bring those arms up. Exhale, dive forward and reach as far as you can as you extend into a deeper stretch here for the hamstring. Breathe in. Settle down as you exhale. Good. And let's come up, taking the hands right by your hips. Slide this foot in now, as close to you can. You don't have to bring it all the way in. You're going to push the hands on the floor, open up through the chest, and feel this left knee push away, getting a wonderful stretch. Wonderful release. Open up the chest. Breathe in. Exhale. A lot going on today. Drop the knee over to the other side. Wrap that right arm. Hug that left knee. Look over the shoulder. You want to keep this left hip down. Nice. And let's come back onto the floor. Lie on our back. Pull the knees into your chest. Good. Rock side to side. And we're going to finish with plow. We've not done this one yet either, but I want you to take your hands under your hips. And option one is just to hang out here. Option two, if you can, bring your knees over your head. And option three, if you're feeling good, tuck the toes over your head. You can take the back of the hands on the lower back and hold it. Elbows are propped up. And keep the shoulders down to help protect the neck, which stays on the floor. Now, if you're feeling really confident, you could bring those knees and wrap them around your forehead and then raise the legs to the sky. Of course, it's advanced, so you can keep those legs down or just keep them over your forehead if you prefer. Good. Extend your right leg or left leg towards the floor. You could touch the toes to the floor. Keep your other leg extended. And then let's bring that leg up and switch sides. And bring it up again. If you're ready, bring those knees around the forehead. Take the hands to the floor and carefully release the spine one vertebrae at a time as you hug those knees in. Good. Rock side to side. All right, guys, we're going to close it out here. We're going to extend the legs out. Extend those arms out. Wiggle your way into the ground. I want you to close your eyes and just take 5 deep breaths here. In through the nose. Feel the belly expand. Exhale, big sigh of relief. 4 more, breathe in and out. 3 more, feel free to breathe out through the nose and out.
Feel the breath getting deeper and slower. Breathe in. Breathe out. One more time. Slow it down. Breathe in. Breathe out. Move the end. Good. You can wiggle around. You could take those knees in. Turn onto your right side for that fetal position, guys. When you're ready, you can take that bottom, that top hand, and push yourself up. Seated position. And I just want you to roll it out, shoulders back and down, taking your hands on your legs, and I want you to breathe in. Guys, I want to thank you so much for joining me for the 7 days. If you want to take it up a notch, go ahead and take a picture of yourself doing one of these workouts, post it on social media, tag my name, and I just want to see those of you that are practicing this, making this part of your journey, and I look forward to the next challenge we do together. Until then, namaste, guys. See you next time.